Today we're going to be talking about the Getac S410, and this is our walkthrough of this newer unit from Getac. This is considered a semi-rugged unit. It is built to the military standard 810H, which is just a little different than the G version, and I'll go over that in a different video. It has an IP rating of 53, so 5-3. And if you don't know what the IP rating is, I have a whole video on that, as well as you can check our blog on the website at bobjohnson.com and see what does an IP rating really mean. So today is the Getac S410, and this laptop actually is very nice. It's got a 14-inch screen. It's a 1920 by 1080 screen resolution, and this screen is touch. So you have a semi-rugged unit with a touch screen, and it's 14-inch to boot. There are a couple of interesting buttons. There's the power button, of course, and then the programmable P1 and P2 keys. So you can make those do open programs or open utilities or whatever you might need it for. It has an LED keyboard. And if you remember, I'm kind of a keyboard nerd. This keyboard is nice and bouncy. I found it quite responsive. It is not as robust, though, as the Dell 5400 series. I found the rugged Dell 5400 series had a much better keyboard than this unit. The processor in this particular one, the setting right here, is an i7. You get 16 gigs of RAM in this unit, as it sets right here. The battery life on this unit is, they say, 10 hours. I think it's going to depend on your usage, but they're claiming a 10-hour battery life. The unit itself weighs 5.25 pounds. That's without the AC adapter. So I find it pretty light. The handle on this unit is a rubberized handle that is quite flexible, so it kind of eases into your hand, unlike the Panasonic, which is just a straight metal handle. This gives you a little more flexibility and comfort when you're carrying it. Port-wise, you can take a look. There is, of course, the wrong side. The ports, you have a USB port right here, and the port covers are right here. They fold down just like this and snap back in. They have a rubber gasket around it to, you know, seal out the water and the dirt. This is the USB port, and it's a 3.0. And then you have over here, you have the SIM card slot, which is right under this metal piece right here, as well as an SD card reader. And then in this port right here, we have another USB port, looks like a 2.0, and this looks like a microphone jack or a headphone jack. Over in the back, more ports, you have more USBs, 3.0s, and then you also have an HDMI port. This port right here is your RJ45 NIC port. And then right here we have your SVGA external monitor port. And then this is your RS232 or serial port, or I call it the DB9 port. And so those are your ports. So it has plenty of ports. It's got a cool look to it. I like the cover. If you look here, it's nice and indented. Gives you a nice feel. It almost looks like a tank or armor or something of that nature, so it's pretty cool. On the bottom, you have your docking port, and this, of course, is your battery port. So the battery is easily removable. You just need to hit the switch on the back there. And then your hard drive is over here. And if you look, it does the same kind of thing. If we push this forward, the hard drive with the hard drive caddie pops right out like that. So they're easily interchangeable and repaired. This one does not include a CD ROM. However, this one has a dummy in it. Overall, I like the Getac. It's got a nice processor, good screen, decent keyboard, programmable keys, nice large mouse pad so that you can get where you need to go with the mouse pointer. Overall, I love it. And that is the Getac S410 walkthrough.